Hey, how's it going, everyone? Daikin here. So a lot of you have been asking me which SSR should they aim to invest in for their main team. So today I'm going to share with you all my thoughts on which SSRs are worth your time from each class. Keep in mind, these are my personal opinions I have formed through playtime and talking with others about character strengths and weaknesses. So this should very much just be a guideline tool and not taken to the literal truth. With that in mind, let's get started. First off, let's talk about warriors. The two SSR warriors that I think are worth your time are Nora and Rudo. When it comes to warriors, I think without question, Rudo is the most noticeable at the moment. He is unique as a ranged warrior with great bond skills for your warrior class, all while remaining element neutral due to light and dart skill attacks. Next character is Nora, who has an easy farmable gear set inside the arena shop that scales to your level. She is also immune to chill and freeze, which is a nice bonus, and overall she has great damage. Next up is healers. There's a lot of controversy around which healers are good and who is the best, but I personally think out of the SSR healers that Kamiko and Undyne are the best ones at the moment. Kamiko is the best rounded healer who can do it all, but not anything exceedingly well. She is great for PvP and PvE. However, I think in certain situations, Undyne outshines her in PvP due to her cleansing ability. This will allow for you to gain the upper hand versus heavy debuffing teams. Next up is mages. Personally, I think all the SSR mages are good in their own way. First up is Athena. Athena seems to have the highest mage damage with a kit compiled of both AoE and single target fire skills. Because of her passive and skills, high crit on her really makes her shine. Next up is Zeus. Zeus packs a great root kit that deals a lot of thunder damage. And with so many rooting skills, she is bound to keep uptime on her talent that gives her additional 30% damage to rooted targets. And lastly is Newton, which is probably the weakest of the bunch, but still has a decent water kit with a bunch of CC such as Shackle, Freeze, Chill, and even Extreme Chill. As far as Rangers, the only character I feel that's really worth it at the moment is Netheria. Netheria has great elemental coverage with a freeze and shackle in her kit. She also has amazing damage when you invest into her masteries. Stacking crit on her isn't also a bad idea as well. And lastly, tanks. When it comes to Guardians, Gillian and Ouroboros are the way to go. While I don't have either of them sadly, their kits just scream great annoying tanks. First up is Gillian. Gillian has an absolute monster tank kit that is great for any content in the game. Because Gillian's kit makes her hard to kill, she works well as stall character for arena defense that's on a timer to kill all the enemies before the timer is up. Not only does she increase her defense and decrease damage taken through active and passive skills, but she also recovers HP when casting skills off successful blocks and when receiving fatal damage every 60 seconds. And Ouroboros. Ouroboros is also no slouch when it comes to being a guardian as well. While not mitigating and recovering as much HP as Gillian, he makes up for it with a low cooldown undying passive, which allows for him to soak up damage for a period of time while not meeting his end. This can be extremely annoying to deal with if your DPS can't deal enough damage before the cooldown resets on the skill. Anyway, that's all I have for this one. If you found the video helpful or think another character is just as good as well, let me know in the comments below. Also, if you liked anything I had to say, drop me a like, I greatly appreciate it, and if you want to hear more from me, follow me on my socials. Also, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you know when the next video goes live. As always, my name is Daikin, and I'll see you next time. Signing out.